Backlund in Madison Square Garden has just won the World Wrestling Federation Championship. Bob Backlund is victorious over superstar Billy Graham. Hello, everyone. This is Vince McMahon in the studios of the USA Cable Network. We wholeheartedly welcome you to the premiere of All American Wrestling. And what better way to begin a premiere by introducing you to the World Wrestling Federation champion, Bob Backlund. We will take you back to that magical moment in Madison Square Garden of February 20, 1978, when Bob Backlund defeated superstar Billy Graham to become the World Wrestling Federation champion. Mr. Backlund has held that distinction for over 5 years now. But through the 5 years, Bob Backlund has paid some dues. We will take you to matches and watch Bob Backlund as he met Ken Patera, as he met the likes of Adrian Adonis, as he met Jesse the Body Ventura, right on up to the magnificent Morocco and more. We'll be back to begin the festivities in Madison Square Garden in a moment.
Playboy, it brings you the best of everything. Behind the pages of Playboy, you'll find the authors who create the best sellers.
You think you've had a fear of success?
Interviewers who reveal the person behind the personality.
But I don't anymore.
Award-winning sports analysts and forecasters who give you an up-close look at the teams, the players, and all the action. Playboy's cartoonists point out the humor in today's world with a rare mix of art and wit. And then there's Playboy's photographers, masters at capturing the sensuous beauty of the world's most breathtaking women.
Lift the shoulder just slightly. Good.
Playboy also tips you off to the latest styles, tunes you in to the hottest sounds, and stirs your spirit of adventure with exciting new ideas. Informative, entertaining, and provocative. Playboy, the one magazine that gives you a monthly ticket to the best of the good life. And right now, you can get 12 months of Playboy delivered right to you for only $18.50. That's half the newsstand price. So enjoy the very best, the wit, wisdom, and imagination of today's most creative people. Become a Playboy subscriber and step into the exciting world of Playboy. To order your subscription, here's all you do.
Just phone toll free, 1-800-USA-1000. Call now and get 12 issues of Playboy for only $18.50. Save $18.50 off the $37 newsstand price. So act now. Phone toll free, 1-800-USA-1000. That's toll free, 1-800-USA-1000.
Backlund behind superstar Billy Graham as Graham makes his way to the rope now. Referee asking for the clean break and Backlund backs off. Backlund really on his toes here tonight in Madison Square Garden. This is a tremendous opportunity. And Graham, with so many successful title defenses, knowing full well he's meeting without a doubt the most scientific challenger ever. Graham quickly behind with those python-like arms. Tremendous strength by the superstar, his greatest asset. Backlund trying to work into the fingers. You see him. Backlund to the side now. Slip the elbow through. Back around. Nice flick by Bob Backlund. Very nicely done, and superstar quickly reaches for the rope. Referee again at goal. Bob Backlund takes him up to the ring. Backlund to give it a break. Backlund getting upset. This is what he's worked so hard for. Former collegiate champion. Scratched, clawed all his way to the top rung of the ladder. Finally now, tonight in Madison Square Garden, he has his opportunity. Over 20,000 fans jam-packing Madison Square Garden, sensing that this just may be the night that superstar loses the title. Crafty superstar. Trying to bury his chin now into Backlund's pectoral. Off the rope. Look at this, sunset took up in the air. Count of one, two, no. Backlund so close, and again, superstar Graham hooking the rope. Graham
very cagey, very smart indeed, knowing at all times the proximity of his whereabouts as it relates to the ropes of the ring. And again, the referee moves Bob Backlund back. It's Backlund the aggressor here in this match. Normally, in the past, we have seen Superstar the aggressor. It's about ready to lock up again. Quickly behind Phil Nelson. Backlund will have a tough time breaking the Phil Nelson of the powerful Superstar Billy Graham. Referee asking Backlund if he wants to submit. Backlund not trying to find a measure of escape as Graham again tightens the hold a bit. Look at that! Nicely done! Not complained by Superstar. Some sort of oil, perhaps. And again, Superstar raising the ire of the would-be champion, Bob Backlund. This young man has so much support. So many fans behind him. Through the months, there's been a concerted effort to keep Bob Backlund away from the top challengers, away from the top champions indeed. But finally, Bob Backlund has a way. Superstar to the rope now. Shoulder block. Down he goes. Powerful Graham off again. Backlund quickly behind him. Puts him over. Sunset flip. We've got a view. No, we do not. No. For a moment, it appeared as though, indeed, we had a new champion in Bob Backlund. There is a certain electricity here tonight in Madison Square Garden. The fans sensing, perhaps, that Bob Backlund just may pull it off. But then again, so many fans have been disappointed thinking that Superstar Graham would bow to defeat. Graham, having been champion now for almost a year, gaining in confidence. Those 22-inch arms have really powered his way through any number of matches. A regular face by the Superstar Graham, who has Backlund now. Up! Slam! Down to the canvas. Now, Superstar Graham again asserting himself. As he comes, no, small package. Where's the referee? One, count it two, and oh, so very, very close. Oh, Bob Backlund appears to be gaining momentum all along. Backlund moving in now, and Graham goes for the ride. And wanting Graham to get up, come at him. This is all the young challenger needed. To feel this momentum going his way. He had all the confidence in the world coming into the match. Graham always staying close to the rope. Backlund must be very careful now. Graham into the rope. Backlund with a drop kick, it misses. Landing on his left shoulder. Could very well have dislocated the shoulder. And again, you see the craftiness, the caginess of Superstar Billy Graham. Kicking the champion, the would-be champion in the back of the head. Massive forearm drives Bob Backlund down to the canvas. Superstar again. You see very little in the way of scientific technique on the part of Superstar Billy Graham. He normally, as we have seen many times here in Madison Square Garden, will win his matches with brute strength. Backlund with a somewhat desperate lunge a moment ago into the midsection, but Graham now drops the elbow again on the back of the head. For the ride, it's Bob Backlund. Superstar Graham, there he goes. Another successful title defense. The Superstar Bear Hug, those python right arm around the waist and midsection of Bob Backlund as Graham begins to squeeze. Backlund hanging in there. Superstar Graham, who's won many, many matches. Wait a minute, Backlund has the elbows. Look, he's taking some leverage away from Superstar. Backlund just may break the superstar bear hug. Backlund trying to find a measure of escape where so many men have not. No, it would appear. Wait a minute, Backlund trying to go to the inside. Earlier on, he was on the outside. Could not get it. You can see the fingers separating. Bob Backlund is going to break the superstar bear hug. Backlund going to the inside, getting momentum. Look at the fingers digging to the pressure. Bob Backlund back over the hip. Nice good time. Backlund will feel the effects of the bear hug, but no, yeah, there we go. Right back at it. Superstar tenacious. Referee asking Bob Backlund if indeed he wants to call it quits at this juncture. Both men in a punishing tight matchup. Graham does not have the leverage down on one knee. Now he's back up. He'll gain more leverage. A little more pressure now on the bear hug. Backlund trying to push the head of Graham back. Now going to the inside again. Trying to work his way down. Backlund knows all the pressure points. Bob Backlund trying to work to the inside. Can't quite get it around. Coming around again. Hey, it's now Bob Backlund with the bear hug on superstar Billy Graham. Graham, for a moment I thought Graham was going to submit. Certainly momentum now has shifted completely back around the other way. The shoulders of Graham with a canvas for two. Hair pulled by Graham. Look at this. We see a desperate superstar Billy Graham, it would appear. Two again. Back up now. Unbelievable sprint by challenger Bob Backlund. In Madison Square Garden here tonight, it's a long way from North Dakota, where he won the NCAA collegiate title. Now, Graham to the run. Abdominal stretch, if he can get it. Yes, indeed, kicks it in quite well now. That could very well be it. No, that's not it. Graham again. Every time you think you have Graham, he comes up with something and you know full well. Wait a minute, Bob Backlund has superstar Billy Graham in the air. There may not be an escape for Graham. He's in the middle of the ring. Atomic knee drop down to the canvas. Backlund covers Graham. One, two, and three. The World Wrestling Federation Championship. A dream come true.
It was indeed a dream come true for Bob Backlund, who still at this moment is the reigning World Wrestling Federation champion. However, the dream would be tested over and over. And without a doubt, one of the toughest opponents Bob Backlund had to face subsequent to his win over superstar Billy Graham was a gentleman by the name of Ken Patera. Without a doubt, one of the strongest human beings in the world at that time and perhaps to this day. Ken Patera rivaled Bob Backlund with awesome power. Superstar Billy Graham had tremendous upper body strength indeed. Ken Patera had it all. And Ken Patera pushed Bob Backlund to the limit. This was a tremendous test for the reigning World Wrestling Federation champion Bob Backlund. And we will take you back to Madison Square Garden when we return and show you, joining in progress, the matchup, Ken Patera against Bob Backlund. We'll be back.
Hi, I'm Porter Wagner. You know there are thousands of people just like yourself who love to sing for their own enjoyment. That's why we're offering the Great Sing-Along Album Set. This is 30 great songs featuring some of Nashville's finest musicians, background singers, so you can sing the lead vocals with your very own professional band. Lyrics of all the songs are included, and you get songs like Rocky Top, Almost Persuaded, Crazy, Tie Yellow Ribbon, Together Again, many more. The Great Sing-Along Album Set comes in your choice of two albums, two 8-tracks, or two cassettes. Lyrics included all just for $14.95, post-paid to your door. This is one of the best ideas I've ever seen for country music fans, music lovers. Here's how you order.
To order your great sing-along album set, COD and credit card holders, call toll-free 800-USA-1000. In Georgia, call 800-222-7272. To save COD charges, send $14.95 to Box 49648, Atlanta, Georgia 30359. Please specify albums, 8-tracks, or cassettes.
The USA Movie presents an emotion-packed suspense thriller.
No warning, no note. The killing complete, the family wiped out. Nobody left to explain.
A story of a woman's frustration, a man's obsession, a marriage that has lost its meaning. The only solution turns the logical into the unthinkable. Hal Holbrook and Louise Fletcher are natural enemies on the USA Movie. At 8 p.m. Eastern, 5 Pacific, tomorrow.
Elizabeth Rollins from USA Hotspots, and as you can see, we're taking a short vacation, but don't worry, we'll be back on the road scouting out more hot groups all around the country. We'll be back on Labor Day with a special encore performance of The Edge and Bonnie Hayes and the Wild Combo at the Echo Beach Club in San Francisco. That's Monday night, September 5th, 10 p.m. Eastern and 7 p.m. Pacific. We'll see you then.
They got a word for girls like me. They got a name that they don't want to use.
But Tara just about rolls them over. One, make it, that's all. Patera came close.
Come on, boy.
Kind of two on Backlund then. Actually, there shouldn't be quite as much pressure on Backlund now. And he's on the canvas because Ken Patera doesn't have the leverage from that position that he had in a standing position. Backlund making his move on Patera now. Backlund on his feet. But again, limp in the arms of Ken Patera. To the canvas, the referee again taking his time and coming over for the count. Patera sensing victory. Perhaps this capacity crowd also sensing that Ken Patera certainly capable of taking Bob Backlund's crown away from him. Again, Bob Backlund now making his move. ...22,000 fans here trying to help Backlund come back. Backlund working to the inside, trying to get the elbows down underneath. The elbows of Ken Patera. If he does, he should be able to break the hold. Backlund trying to force his elbows down with all his might. But meanwhile, subject to more punishment is Ken Patera in the standing position, has the leverage factor going for him again. Backlund pulls out. Now, back to the inside. And once again, Patera's strength prevailing. Back and reaching for the hook leg. Now, look at this. Look at that. Oh, yeah. Railing with the pain. Backlund really surprising Ken Patera. Using his knee, ramming it on the base of the spine. Headbutt by Backlund. A right hand by Backlund. Backlund off the rope, shoulder block, both wrestlers going down. Oh no, he's gonna pin him. He's gonna pin him, one. No, he's not. Referee it with a one. Ken Patera with Backlund. No, Backlund Backlund blocks the hold. It's Patera. No, he's not up either. Patera, but there he is. Referee counting both principles. Backlund covers him. One, where? That's all. Backlund covering Patera a moment ago with instinct. Oh, no. Backlund almost rolling to the outside of the square circle. Covered by Patera. Backlund will not give up. He just keeps coming right back at you. But the same is true of Ken Patera. Two phenomenal competitors in the squared circle here in the main event tonight. Patera on the top rope now. Patera right across Backlund. Patera. Court bullet, full Nelson. He holds him. But no, he doesn't. Good job by Backlund. Backlund on his feet. Oh, well. Backlund knocking the referee almost out of the ring. Ken Patera shoved Backlund into the referee. Or we should say, Patera shoved Backlund toward the ropes and the referee was in the way. And unfortunately, the referee is not moving. Full Nelson now applied. Ken Patera has a full Nelson on Bob Backlund. Backlund breaks a hold. The referee is still out. The referee perhaps struck his head on the corner post. We couldn't tell from our vantage point. Another official in the squared circle now. Patera Backlund swinging out at Patera. And Backlund choking Ken Patera. They are really going at it. Backlund sends him out. We have a brawl going. Oh, they're trying to keep Patera away from Backlund. Trying to keep Backlund away from Patera as well.
Obviously, that match in Madison Square Garden erupting into a real Donnybrook. Bob Backlund not getting the Duke that night, and indeed, there would be on many occasions in which he would not be victorious. Nonetheless, retaining the World Wrestling Federation title, of course, everyone realizing that the title will change when there is a submission or a pin. In a moment, when we return, we're going to take you back to matches in 1982, a very rough year for champion Bob Backlund. Before we do that, we'd like, if we may now, to give you an address for those of you wishing to comment. Those of you wishing to comment on this week's USA Premier of all American wrestling. Simply write to Wrestling, Post Office Box 1538, Greenwich, Connecticut, 06836. We do indeed welcome your comments on this premier issue of All American Wrestling. When we return, we'll take you to a very rough year for the World Wrestling Federation champion, Bob Backlund.
Ta-da!
Well, your first job interview. Now, Tommy, be polite.
Mom, I'll be fine.
Ask good questions, sit up straight.
I'm 17 years old, stop babying
me. Don't chew gum and pay attention.
Mom, come on, I can handle it. It's a part-time job.
I'm sorry, dear. Good luck. He's not my little boy anymore. He's moving into the adult world. I won't be able to help him out all the time. Not that he wants me to.
But I've done one important thing for him, and I wasn't interfering. I've started a financial program for Tommy with Globe's Young American Plan. It's young people's life insurance. Tommy's covered for $10,000 for just $40 a year. And starting at age 26, he can borrow against the policy, take the cash value, or continue the coverage at a higher rate.
It's a big financial advantage. And all I did was call a toll-free number. This Globe policy protects his ability to get insurance. As long as the premiums are paid on time, the policy can't be canceled. I feel good about that. Globe makes all these advantages easy to afford.
$1 insures your child for the introductory period with this offer.
That's $10,000 coverage for $1. We can't live our kids' lives for them, but we can help them. No matter how far he goes from home, Tommy will have the life insurance coverage I gave him. I covered her, too. Hi, honey. How's school?
Hi, Mom.
They're worth it, every bit.
For protection for your children, call 1-800-228-1202 toll-free. That's 1-800-228-1202. You'll receive complete information and applications by return mail. No obligation, of course, or write Globe Life, Oklahoma City. But for fastest service, call 1-800-228-1202 now.
1982, as we stated before, was a very tough year for World Wrestling Federation champion Bob Backlund. Manager Freddie Blassie introduced something known as an East-West connection. Adrian Adonis from New York City, Jesse the Body Ventura from California. These two gentlemen would really give Bob Backlund a run for his money. We will now take you to Philadelphia at the Spectrum. Bob Backlund squaring off against the master of a sleeper hold known as Goodnight Irene, Adrian Adonis.
Adonis cowering in the corner now, and here in Philadelphia, Bob Backlund is really picking up the momentum. Adonis whipped to the buckle. Oh, my. Upside down in a most compromising position. This capacity crowd at the Philadelphia Spectrum, knowing full well that Bob Backlund could lose the title to a very scientifically oriented wrestler in this Adrian Adonis, and it has been a hard-fought match today. Look at this. Adonis, I could, oh, forget it. Backlund. Both men down as the referee, Dick Rowley, picks up the count, but it should be Adonis the top. A cover by Backlund. No, Adonis has proven to be one of the toughest competitors Bob Backlund has ever faced. Oh, no, there it is. Good night, Irene. We're going to have a new champion crowned in Philadelphia tonight. Good night, Irene, on Bob Backlund. No one has escaped the sleeper hold of Adrian Adonis. Bob Backlund going to sleep before this capacity crowd in Philadelphia. Adrian Adonis just moments away from having his hand raised and the new world bound on a canvas. Unfortunately, Bob Backlund going to sleep. He has been, without a doubt, truly one of the great World Wrestling Federation champions. But Adrian Adonis had come to Philadelphia and has slapped that sleeper hold on Bob Backlund, and Adonis now putting Bob Backlund to sleep. Bob Backlund. No. Backlund has 16,000 fans behind him. Backlund is coming back around. No one has ever done that before. Bob Backlund is almost on his feet. Adonis has lost the touch of this. Goes, look at this. Pushing to him. Adrian Adonis, the pin. No, wait a minute. Backlund, pushing back. Oh, Backlund wins. Right there.
Obviously a very close call for World Wrestling Federation champion Bob Backlund. He was to have many close calls in 1982. We spoke earlier of the East-West connection. We saw Adrian Adonis representing the East. We now would take you to Madison Square Garden. Jesse, the Body Ventura, the western part of Fred Blassie's East-West connection. We now take you to the Body Ventura, joining the match in progress in Madison Square Garden.
Square up by the Body. Reverse. Again, the foot across the throat of Backlund.
Count him!
Shoulders have been down for some time. Referee Kutsky really taking his time. Ball driver. Things looking very bleak for Backlund. Cover by Ventura. Again. Talk about a slow count. Come on, give us a break. Cover by Ventura. Get another slow count. That should do it. We're going to have a new champion if there's any count at all. One that time. There's the Body Breaker. It's all over. The Body Breaker, always ending in submission. We have a new champion. Chalk it up right here. Back to no. Goodness, Backlund. No. Backlund now, whipped it to the rope. Hold him back.
Obviously, as we saw, a very fast count with the then guest referee, Ivan Putski. You wonder if Ivan Putski had not been guest referee, what the outcome of that match would really be. 1982 continued to be a very rough year for champion Bob Backlund, and another contingent from the West Coast would challenge him, one born with the proverbial silver spoon in his mouth. In regards to Playboy Buddy Rose, we take you to Madison Square Garden, joining the match in progress with the Playboy.
Right. Buddy Rose now going out to the apron. To the rope. On the way to the top rope, Buddy Rose. Here it comes. Go! Drop kick by Playboy Buddy Rose. Hooks the leg. Both wrestlers beginning to tire a bit. A tip and a suplex, and there's a chicken wing. Trying to get it off. That's it.
Bob Backlund had perfected a hold. We saw it there, the chicken wing, chicken wing crossface. A hold that certainly would take him on to victory match after match. But when we return, ladies and gentlemen, we will take you back to Madison Square Garden and almost a rematch of some 5 years in the making in reference to superstar Billy Graham. We'll take you to actions, a different superstar Billy Graham than we saw back in 1978. Very different indeed. We'll be back with that in a moment.
Motown in America brings you 50 certified number one hits by the Motown superstars. Here's a 5-record anniversary collection that'll keep you dancing.
Baby.
Jimmy, wipe a heat wave, burning in my
number one Motown hits on five records, three cassette tapes, or three 8-track tapes. Your choice, 1995.
Oh, baby,
by the Motown Superstars. 50 number one hits on 5 LPs, 3 8-track or cassette tapes, 1995. Get the rock, roll, and soul value of the season.
To order, use your MasterCharge or Visa. Call free 800-USA-1000. Georgia residents, call 1-800-222-7272. Or save COD and handling charges by sending 1995 for 5 records, 3 8-tracks, or 3 cassettes to Motown 50. Box 49648, Atlanta, Georgia. Please specify cassettes, records, or 8-track tapes.
1978, when Bob Backlund won the World Wrestling Federation title, defeating superstar Billy Graham, was a rather controversial title change indeed. There was some comments made to Mr. Graham's foot being on the bottom rope. Mr. Graham himself, a very controversial individual. At that time, weighing some 200 and perhaps 70 some odd pounds, mammoth proportion individual. Regarding his strength, very few individuals, as we stated before, were as strong as Graham. However, Mr. Graham returned to the World Wrestling Federation after going into seclusion, after indeed studying the martial arts skills in the Orient. And we will see a completely different superstar Billy Graham when he makes his return to the World Wrestling Federation, when he makes his bid to, again, reclaim what he felt was justifiably his and was stolen from him, the World Wrestling Federation title. We will show you the desperation of superstar Billy Graham and his actions when we return. We go now to the tape.
Hot superstar Billy Graham over in the corner. Graham walking around, taking a look at Backlund's match. And Graham getting something. What's he have? Wait a minute. He just picked up the championship belt. Graham holding it high. And no doubt Bob Backlund is looking right at superstar right now.
Backlund has to be careful. Look at Sweet Anson moving behind him.
Here he comes. We can get a word here with Mr. Graham. Mr. Graham, what is the meaning of this?
This is my belt, Mr. Announcer. This belt belongs to superstar Billy Graham. Not that punk in the middle of the ring. He has no business. He has shamed this belt. Man has shamed this belt. Disgraced this belt. Has that done dishonor to the Worldwide Wrestling Federation. I'm the only man that deserves this belt. I'm the only man. If I can't have it, nobody can have it.
Superstar Billy Graham and look at this. Now Backlund wants his belt back, looking down on superstar. Superstar going after Backlund.
Here comes Skolin. Oh, I can't believe it. I can't believe what superstar Billy Graham is doing. He's tearing the belt apart. He is ripping it apart of that gold belt.
Little what do you think you're doing?
If I can't have this belt, nobody can have it.
What do you think you're doing?
I can't believe what this man is doing. First he said it's his, now he's destroying it. I can't believe it.
There's your belt.
Actually, I wanted to destroy Bob Backlund's belt.
These despicable actions by superstar Billy Graham setting off the fuse of Bob Backlund, indeed. He would meet superstar Billy Graham in a series of matches and enjoy every moment of it. And it would culminate in a special lumberjack match, a most unusual event, as it took place in Madison Square Garden, Graham against Bob Backlund.
This is a special lumberjack match, just a culmination of almost 5 years of martial art training by superstar Billy Graham. It was in this very same arena almost 5 years ago that superstar Billy Graham lost the World Wrestling Federation title to Bob Backlund. He's back here to reclaim. Shoulder block by Backlund, both in back row. But wait a minute. Big Sweet Hansen, the guest referee, sandwiched by both Backlund and superstar. And the Big Sweet is a 300-pounder, and he's going nowhere. Backlund now, uh-oh. Backlund could call into some unfriendly hands outside. There's Playboy Bunny Rose out there. Backlund. Backlund on that iron gate, backed into it now. Jay Strongbow over to help out along with a whole host of others. This is a lumberjack match. Some 16 wrestlers surrounding that ring, making sure that both principals will stay inside the ring until we have indeed a victor. Well, now they're pushing both Backlund and Superstar back into the ring. Superstar, a little action going on outside, as you might suspect. Playboy Buddy Rose, Tony Garea, Drew Strongbow. Back in the ring now. There's that martial art. Look at that, right to the throat, and Backlund right out on the apron. Jump right back in. For a moment, it appeared as though Backlund were knocked to the rope, and then maybe again he was trying to get out of dodge. Ooh, another vicious chop to the throat. Rocky Johnson there trying to encourage the champion to get back in. Things not looking too well at all for Bob Backlund at this moment. Graham with another chop. Oh. It looked like maybe Bob Backlund was trying there to get away from Backlund, rather Graham, and trying to get to the outside. It looks like it's all superstar Billy Graham, and perhaps it would only be poetic justice that Graham reclaims his World Wrestling Federation championship right here in the very same ring that he lost to Bob Backlund almost 5 years ago. This is no doubt a different superstar Billy Graham than we saw 5 years ago. Relying strictly, or at least mostly, on his martial arts skills, Graham taking his time moving in and the champion slumping in the corner. Graham in this rugged type match, well, it's really taking its toll mostly, I would suspect, on Bob Backlund. Another shoulder block. Backlund put over the top rope. Look, it's trying to get leverage now. Someone outside kicking the ankle off of Backlund. This has been a grueling match. A decisive match. Superstar bear hug. Graham knowing that this is not going to defeat Backlund. Oh, look at that. Backlund really laid one in. To the buckle, superstar. Oh, about, oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute, there's the chicken wing. Bob Backlund has perfected the cross-face chicken wing. That could very well be it. Bob Backlund slapping the chicken wing on superstar Billy Graham. Sweet Hansen, who has proven thus far to be somewhat impartial, but you wonder whether or not Graham is Graham is going to submit here. Sweet Hansen, guest referee, has no one has ever escaped from this hold, and it is always moving. Look at the eye of Graham. It's almost bulging out of his head. Backlund really pouring on the pressure. Graham motioning, is he, I think he's motioning choke. Graham trying to, he's motioning choke, I believe. It looks like Sweet Hansen confused. Hansen wondering what to do here. Is Graham going to submit? Apparently, yes. Superstar Billy Graham submits, and the cross-face chicken wing, a hold Bob Backlund has perfected, is victorious.
Bob Backlund pulling through 1982, even though it was an extremely tough year for the World Wrestling Federation champion, but not as tough as this year. With every match, Bob Backlund faced with even more extraordinary caliber of opponents. And in a moment, we'll take you to 1983, some of the outstanding matches, including highlights from the unbelievable, magnificent Morocco when we return.
I wear my marigold everywhere.
Marigold, the only jewelry that is as intimate as your skin. Marigold is a 24-karat gold finish that will never peel, tarnish, or discolor, and it's hypoallergenic. The Marigold Designer Collection is only available through this exclusive television offer. Each collection includes one 16-inch herringbone chain and one 18-inch herringbone chain, which can be worn separately or together. Also included is one pair of beautifully tailored love knot earrings and one pair of designer hoop earrings, all in a specially designed travel case. The Marigold Collection weighs 14.5 pennyweight. An equivalent collection of pure gold would retail for over $700. Each collection is registered and is accompanied by a lifetime guarantee. Order now and receive this beautiful matching bracelet free. Call today, 1-800-USA-1000, or send $19.95 to Marigold, P.O. Box 49648, Atlanta, Georgia.
Last year in the waning moments.
Got an open bat and he has it.
This year, the battle cry in Coral Gables is revenge on the premiere of USA's College Football 83. The Miami Hurricanes look to tame aerial artist Wayne Pease and the Florida Gators. Catch the spirit of College Football 83. Florida and Miami, premiering tonight at 9 p.m. Eastern, 6 Pacific on USA. USA hits you with a double dose of Penn and Fever on the next edition of Thursday Night Baseball. First in the AL East, Dave Winfield and the New York Yankees slugging out with Simmons, Yount, and the wall-banging Milwaukee Brewers. Then it's on to Los Angeles, where the Dodgers try to stay in the NL West race when they battle the Cincinnati Reds. Make a big hit with a key twin bill on Thursday Night Baseball. Live at 8:30 p.m. Eastern, only on USA. May not be seen in some areas.
In 1983, there would emerge in the World Wrestling Federation a tremendous competitor. A competitor destined to become a champion. And indeed, when we take you to Madison Square Garden momentarily, we will show you champion against champion, the still at this moment reigning intercontinental title holder, the magnificent Morocco, who had recently just won his intercontinental championship, going after Bob Backlund in Madison Square Garden, one of Backlund's toughest matches ever, and a no-holds-barred matchup. We take you to the Garden.
Incidentally, there's no time limit in this match. Maybe we should have packed the lunch. Bob Backlund, the envy of every youngster who ever put on a pair of wrestling shoes, and rightly so, because he is a great representative of professional wrestling. Whenever possible, taking time out to go to hospitals, children's homes, and high schools and colleges to meet, sit down, and talk with amateur wrestlers. Sets up a great many tournaments throughout the country and is an asset, is a champion 24 hours a day. Still holding on to that side headlock. Seems to be into the tights here. He did. Broke the hold with a shoulder block. Backlund went outside the ring on the shoulder block. Morocco coming up quicker than Bob is. Well, that'll make your ears ring. Slam, rolling slam. Backlund takes him over. He's got the leg hook. He almost got him. Nice maneuver there by Backlund. Backlund with the heavy slam on Morocco.
The magnificent Morocco continues to reign supreme over the Intercontinental title, although notwithstanding, perhaps Mr. Morocco's still ongoing bid to gain the World Wrestling Federation Championship. However, Bob Backlund, having escaped that attempt by Morocco to dethrone him, will take you now to Philadelphia, and Bob Backlund meeting a rather underrated wrestler in Philadelphia, a gentleman by the name of Iron Mike Sharp, who surprised an awful lot of people. At the head of that list would be champion Bob Backlund. We take you to the Spectrum.
Backlund on top of him. One, two, kicked out.
Whew. Backlund almost knocked the wind out of himself on that suplex.
I'll tell you, these guys are worn out. You've got to be conditioned to do this. I don't know, can he do it again to him?
He's going for the pile driver again.
Looks like it. I don't know. What?
He's not going to get it. Sharp powered right out of it with a backdrop. Look at Sharp adjusting. Looks like he's adjusting something there, Dick. He's doing something to that forearm wrap. Referee Dick Worley did not see it. Whatever it was. Shoots back the knee. Oh, he ducked it.
That's way
into the ropes. Sunset flip roll up with the bridge. He got him.
Bob Backlund enjoying success in Philadelphia on that given night. But subsequent to that match, another challenge in Philadelphia. The Russian Bear, Ivan Koloff, a former World Wrestling Federation champion. When he was champion, he was somewhere around the neighborhood of 280 pounds. But here we'll find Ivan Koloff at a very lean 236 pounds, challenging the World Wrestling Federation champion Bob Backlund in Philadelphia. We take you back to the Spectrum.
Backlund kicked out. Do you believe that?
2.5. Came very close to having a new champion right here in the Spectrum tonight on Prism.
Body, backbreaker. Down he goes. Two! Backlund still hurting in the midsection. Koloff going to bring him into the ropes. Do it all over again. There comes the boot. The Russian boot to the midsection. Oh, the bear hug. Backlund still at the receiving end of the bear hug. Got to get out of this. Will he? Won't he? I don't know.
Well, you got to get out any way you can. Big finger in the eye, stick your hand in his mouth. You got to do whatever you can.
Whatever.
This guy's looking to take your title. When Koloff slaps that bear hug on you, it's like a python wrapping around you.
Backlund, I thought, was on the verge of putting away Koloff on the ropes in the corner a few minutes ago, but I think his energy was wasted at that point in time, briefly. He couldn't do a thing about it, but now he can. Double knee chop to the head. Backlund into the turnbuckle. Oh!
Oh! Chicken wing, he's got the chicken wing.
He's got the chicken wing, and here he goes,
baby. It's locked. It's locked on there.
I think, maybe. That's over. It's all over.
When we return, ladies and gentlemen, we will have with us here in our USA studios the World Wrestling Federation champion, Bob Backlund. We certainly hope you're enjoying thus far this premier presentation of All American Wrestling. To that end, we certainly invite you to comment. Simply write to Wrestling, Post Office Box 1538, Greenwich, Connecticut, 06836 for your commentary on this premier broadcast of All American Wrestling. When we return, we shall have with us the World Wrestling Federation champion, Bob Backlund.
Do you have all the facts you need to face your major expenses this year? What if you have to replace your car? How can you choose one that will spend more time on the road than in the repair shop? Is this the year you have to paint your home? How will you know which brand will stand up best and cost less? If this is the year you give up on your old TV, how much will it cost you for a more reliable model? Before you spend a penny, arm yourself with the facts. Call this toll-free number and get your copy of Consumer Reports' 1983 Buying Guide issue, an immediate source of shopping relief. It's yours, free, with your paid subscription to Consumer Reports, the magazine that helps you get the most for every dollar you spend on products and services. Which breakfast cereals contain more than 40% total sugar? Why kerosene heaters are a safety hazard? How much do you have to spend for a good food processor? Consumer Reports can give you these facts because we accept no outside advertising and we're nonprofit. You'll find our test results in handy ratings charts that measure from better to worse. Which paper towel was really most absorbent? Which pocket camera performed best? In Consumer Reports, you'll find out if buying a home will really save you money. Why this $35 drill was a better buy than more expensive models. Whether the new diet pills work and if they're safe. Call this number now to get 11 regular issues of Consumer Reports, plus two free gifts with your paid subscription.
One, your 1983 buying guide issue. Two, this book on common health problems and products, The Medicine Show. Plus, the 1984 buying guide issue when published as part of your subscription. All this for $14.
Phone toll free 1-800-USA-1000 now to save more than 50% off the single copy cost. That's 1-800-USA-1000.
With us now, ladies and gentlemen, the World Wrestling Federation champion, Mr. Bob Backlund. And Bob Backlund, I must say, we at the USA Network are honored to have you as our subject of the premier broadcast of All-American Wrestling.
Vince, it's really great to be here. It's an honor. And, you know, it's been a long, hard road up to the championship. But and I've always been an underdog all my life, even at home in Princeton, Minnesota. I was put down because I was from the wrong side of the river. But I've always wanted to be the best at whatever I did. I can remember going home and baling hay at night. And I always wanted to throw the bales a little higher. When I was starting wrestling, when I was 10 years old, I was put down because of being from the other side of the river. And kids from there never got to be successes. I always wanted to be the best at wrestling, even when I was 10 years old. And in high school, I wrestled against kids from big cities, and the coaches always put me down. They never picked me to win it, and I always caused them problems because I came out on the top in high school. And then when I started college, Vince, it was all starting over again. Competition was tough, and even in the Nationals, coaches never picked me to win it because of I was from a small college again. I was just a small town boy, small college. And that NCAA tournament was beautiful to win after not being picked. Then I started professional wrestling, Vince, and I thought I had it made when I started. I thought because of my wrestling background, I had it made in professional wrestling. But I started out in the very bottom. Nothing was easy. I had to sleep in my car, in the trunk of my car, for about 6 months because I couldn't afford to stay in a motel. I had to work out in the YMCAs. I had to go on the mat and roll around with the kids and with the wrestlers at the YMCAs. It was a real battle getting the WWF title. I wasn't an instant success in professional wrestling. I had to work every day. And I want to keep this title. I don't know how long it's going to go. I just take them one at a time. There's a lot of people in the future. Sergeant Slaughter, Superstar, the Masked Superstar, Don Morocco. They're all shooting for you. But I'm proud to be there. I'm proud to represent all those friends I've made in the past 5 years. And I'm going to keep giving it that 100%. And I don't want to let anybody down.
Bob Backlund, we thank you for being our guest here on the premier broadcast of All-American Wrestling. Next week, ladies and gentlemen, we will take you to this, an individual whom we neglected to mention, facing Bob Backlund. Indeed, this, ladies and gentlemen, one of the most phenomenal athletes in the history of professional wrestling, because Bob Backlund was put to the test as never before by this man, and this man, Superfly Jimmy Snuka, will be the subject of next week's All-American Pro Wrestling right here on the USA Network. Join us, ladies and gentlemen, next week for the Superfly Jimmy Snuka story. Without a doubt, one of the most fantastic stories in professional wrestling. Join us next week for more All-American Wrestling.